So I turned my carriage stop screw, moved the bed in, locking the carriage down. Now I'm going to come back. I'm going to take a little bigger cut this time. And a little bit of a vibration. Let me lower the part some. Now this cut might be just a little bit on the large side. Put some lube on this. Ooh, that's how you mess up your oil can. Yeah, I'm gonna have to back that off. That's just too much cut. I'm going to raise the part. Go back across. Seems to cut in this direction a little better. I notice I'm getting a lift there, which is an indication that either the bit is moved or my block is moved. So I need to check that. I don't think the bit has moved in. Is it possible the block has moved out? The block would have moved in to leave that lip there. See, we have this ramp here now. Need to resolve what's going on. See, a proper holder for this tool would have a set screw in this flat and wouldn't let it move. I don't believe the tool is moved. Oh, I know what has happened. The carriage has moved away. Is that possible? Wow, look at that. I'm to the end of the lead screw. Now you really can't machine off the face of the part here. I'm not climb milling. It seems to vibrate and have a little more difficulty when I come back this direction. And I think what might be the problem is loose gibbs on the carriage. All right, I tightened up this back gib and the gib that pushes against the bed and pulls the carriage against all of its slack in that direction. Tightening up this gib where it squeezes on the bottom of the bed is going to be more problematic. I have to take the carriage apart to do that. Like speeding in that direction better. Got some oil laying on that lip. Whoa! Alright. That sucked. I think I moved everything. Probably every time I do an operation on this lathe, I'm going to find another problem. Look at this. The nut that I'm driving into to move it up and down, its fastener isn't tight. That isn't what caused this problem, but when I tried to plunge cut, which I can't plunge cut with that evidently, it pulled the work into it, and so now my vise is turned this way. So I got to re-square it up. Now, I've realized that I can square it up against this machine's surface by putting it against the chuck here. So I'll have to, of course, then I lose my depth stop. I'm going to have to think about this. See how I can do this without fouling up my depth stop. Solved it. I believe a 1-2-3 block. Oh, it hits my depth stop. Show you what I'm doing here. I need to space off of the chuck to pick up square. We can see how out of alignment that is. I'm not really impressed with these milling attachments. Aha, I can push that all together. This should be perfectly square now. Once I machine the other side, it'll be parallel if I happen to be off a little bit. Not the end of the world if there's a small mistake there. See, the problem with these vices is these gibs in the back are holding it down in the back, but there's nothing holding it down in the front. I've looked at this and wondered if I could drill this and machine the cross slide and put a fastener in here. Probably would be a great improvement on these milling attachments for the Atlas lathes. Maybe we'll do that as a later project. Alright. Let's raise this back up. Get back to what we were doing. But this time we're not going to plunge cut anything. It's about all the cross slide screw that I have. Lock it down. Make sure these are tight. come back when I'm on the finish pad. Well, I don't have a real good way to measure this or to move the carriage an accurate amount. I'll tell you, before a guy spent $250, which is about what these milling attachments go for nowadays, if a guy spent $250 on one of these, I think he'd be way, way better ahead. Put that towards a small milling machine. Because you can't do much with this. Probably the smallest, most incapable milling machine could do more than you could do with this vise. Sounds like a great idea. You know I want one because I'm a collector of everything, but I'm not exactly impressed. Wow. 1 inch 597. So I got to take off about 10 more thousandths. Probably two more passes. Okay, 1 inch 589, 1 inch 590, 1 inch 589, I got it within a thou. That's as good as I'm going to get it. Considering I don't have gauge blocks, I don't have a calibrated carriage stop. I'm just taking a swing, a wag at it. Well, I was determined before I went to bed tonight to get one side of this cut down. So tomorrow...